importance of photography is that we all recording what's happening right now. So very often I think it's, I don't know, there are some people right now that use photography as a way to express themselves in many different ways, and which is good. But I think the really great things about photography, one of the great things is for sure that it's about the reality. So everything that you're shooting is dying in exactly the same moment that you are doing it. So it's never going to happen again, and it's a sort of document of reality right now that you are living, and that's very important. I think, I repeat, that you have always to deal with what's happening in front of you. So you can't really manage to have this creative work that you are doing in a complete free way, which is a good thing, it's not a bad thing. That's why I pass from be a painter to be a photographer. Because when you are a painter, you can just do whatever you want. You can create whatever you want. You can have a person wearing a mask, or, I don't know, a zebra wearing a hat. It's very easy because you just have to draw it. But it remains in the reality of your painting. It has nothing to do with the real, which I think it's very important. It's what attracted me to photography. Is what is not photography. That's something that I really don't like. So everything that is videography and video in general, I think is very different from photography. And people who do photography as a video and vice versa, that's not really my thing. And why? Because when you do a video, you don't have to group everything together in one single picture. So famous, like, you know, Cartier-Bresson, you know, the concept of the moment that defines everything. That's the good thing about photography, and it's a good thing about painting too, and sculptures is the same, but it's very different to, you know, what you can see in a movie or in a documentary, which is a series of, like, you know, moving images that tell you a story. I don't think that photography will tell you a story. It's more like a poem. It's the difference between poetry and just a novel. Novel is more like a book. It tells you a story. It can tell you a story well, because it's well written, or bad. It can be interesting or not, but that's about who actually write the novel. But it tells you a story with characters, with people, with metaphors and stuff. Photography or poetry, it tries to tell you the absolutes. So when we see a picture of a prostitute, for example, from Cartier-Bresson, for example, it tells you about prostitution itself. It's not about that prostitute. So it's not really, you know, a document of that person, is not the idea of that person. It's more about, it will help you to think about the matter itself. It's immortal, it could be today, tomorrow, and in the future. It will always be in your mind when someone tells you, oh, there is a prostitute. You will always have that picture in your mind, and that's photography. That's when you really hit the mark in photography, when you hit the absolute. The way that you appreciate things on Instagram takes, it's quite different from what it should, you know, should be, in my opinion, because it's fast. You will always like something very, very emotional, very fast, because it's come with a different speed directly in your mind. So there is a beautiful girl with a beautiful landscape, beautiful colors, very bright colors, and then you click like. You don't even know why you click like. And that will change photography, because many photographers, in order to acquire more likes, they are changing their way to see a photograph. So, of course, also be forced to see photographs inside a phone
which is vertical, is very small, it's very high resolution actually, but it's very different from 60, 50 years ago. So that for sure is changing photography. Well, it's very personal to me, because my Photoshop teacher is Claudio Palmisano, so which it's one of probably of the best photojournalism retoucher in the world. And I saw many photographs of war reportage and so on. I have to say that Photoshop itself, and it's a very practical, very analog, in a way, tool, because it actually just reproduces whatever you were able to do with the darkroom, but with digital. Thing is that exactly what happened for darkroom, you can overprocess your photos, creating some effects that could be like gross or pleasant. So it depends by your skills, your test, your knowledge of the tool. But it's not very automatic, it's not like an Instagram filter. And so I don't really believe that Photoshop is a bad thing. I use Photoshop in a way that, and many others, that it's not really visible. For example, I don't over retouch the skin, I leave the skin as it is, but of course I correct some, you know, here and there, some points that I don't actually like. Or maybe I leave it there, I mean, it depends by the picture. But at the end, we do need Photoshop in the same way we needed like the darkroom and then to print, which are two missing elements right now. But you can find them back, if you come from film like me, into Photoshop. So Photoshop is a good thing, just you have to use it in the right way. Fashion trend. Well, I come from like 3 years of shooting cars, and I don't even own a driver license. So I come from a very particular mindset right now. And I used to do fashion before, and now I'm coming back into fashion, especially like a kind of fashion that I think is growing, kind of dark gothic. We saw a few days ago some collections that actually even resemble like Italian Renaissance kind of designs, which is very fine, and it's something that really suits my style. And I'm very happy of these new trends that are coming along. I really hope that they are not going into cosplay, but I think it will eventually include some elements from manga, from movies, like cartoons and 3D, you know, animation movies, because this is what is the pop culture right now, so for sure it will include everything. That's a very, very nice question to answer for me, because I have so many. The thing is that I did the Academy of Fine Art in Rome, and just the opposite side of the road, we have this beautiful bookstore only for art books, and it's owned by a family for generations. It's a very nice place where you can know, you know, like all the artists, of course, from Renaissance to medieval times until today. And I remember that my first shocks are when I saw Stephen Shore Uncommon Places. Yeah, for sure, because it was something that was beyond photography. It was clear that it was beyond photography. It was really the connection between painting as a thing, not that the photos looked like paintings, but the same intent. So the will was not to making a photograph, was to making a painting. And that was very important to me. And of course, like Peter Lindbergh and Daido Moriyama, of course, many others like Araki. I think all of those, Irving Penn, especially, I guess Irving Penn is something that always is in my, you know, in my life somehow, because I have this very graphical way of photograph, which I really love. It's something that is simple, it's dark, it's have a great impact, but it's not too much. It's not overdone. It's never, you know, over the test. It's always inside the situation, but it tells you everything about it. And it's all about the style. It's not really what he was doing. He could have done like a still life or a catalog for Vogue, and it was exactly the same. And I think he's one of the greatest photographers of all the time. Sanders is probably the kind of research that I thought was the peak of a certain kind of photography. Very hard to reproduce today with the same impact, because as I was saying before, it's a document of reality. So he had a very, you know, specific, a very peculiar, very interesting kind of humanity all around him. So he just cataloged all the, you know, people that was living in the same city as him, and it's very interesting because we know what happened after the photos, so that's why it makes all of those photos very interesting. And Walker Evans for sure. I saw an amazing exhibition when I was in Rome. I don't remember, it was like 20 years ago, maybe more. They were very, very big prints. Very big prints in black and white, beautiful black and white. And I say, this is fantastic, this is really fantastic. And that's why I went into large format photography first, because I saw those prints with all of those details. That tells you everything about where that situation was. There was something that really tells you, I don't know, what kind of America it was. There was a lot of passion, a lot of, you know, it's true that devil is in the details, because there's everything. Ansel Adams, of course, was one of my teachers. And I guess I have explored many, many different styles of photography in my life. So. Okay, let's talk about equipment. I want to a review here, but I tell you a little bit, because I think that photography is something that, let's say, like when you paint, you have just a brush. So it's not very important the shape of the brush. Well, it is a little bit, but not, you don't have to relate yourself to a machine, okay? So, photography is interesting because it's doing art through an actual machine. There's not another art that can do that. So you have to actually relate emotionally, and we are all different in that way, to a certain machine that will create a certain effect. And then you will see that result and say, oh, this one I like less, and only you know why. And then I think that that's the beauty. So I have, I'm working normally with a Phase One, which is quite old, because this is a 45P plus, which was the last of the CCD. So it's very, very similar to film photography. This is probably the closest you can get right now to film photography using digital. And why I'm saying that, because I do like film photography, because I start with film photography, and I like to slow down. So this one is not the latest Nikon. You have to slow down, think what you're doing.